Welcome in this week Technical Tuesday with NXCam. Today I will demonstrate a couple small tricks related to Streamline operation. At the example part, which you can see here, I want to create finishing operation for top surface. I will use Streamline for this. As a cut area, I specify top surface. Under Streamline Drive method settings, we can see flow curves are created automatically basing on cut area. I will now adjust some of Streamline settings like cut pattern, step over and cut step mode. I always use cut step as tolerance. After toolpath is generated, we can see some unnecessary retract and engage motions. To understand why it is happening, you should know that when we select some faces in our part as cut area, all other faces are treated as protected areas, so tool will not touch them. What I usually do in such situations is deselecting faces from cut area. When no cut area is selected, NX treats all faces of the part as cut area. But if we will deselect cut area, we will lose Streamline flow curves, which were created automatically. To avoid this, we can change selection method option to specify. This way, we removed relation between Streamline curves and cut area. So we can now deselect cut area and Streamline curves will stay untouched. This way, we achieved smooth tool path along entire surface which we want to machine. Next option, which I want to draw your attention to, is tool position. First operation which I created uses tool position as on. I make a copy of this operation and change this parameter to tangent 2. Here you can see the difference. Notice where is contact point between tool and the part. With tool position option set to on, NX drives tooltip along drive area. As you can see here, lower part of the surface will be not machined. This is the lowest pass. Tooltip is aligned with drive geometry outline, but contact point between tool and the part is a little higher. And here is how it looks with tool position set to tangent 2. NX drives tool contact point along drive area. When we analyze lowest pass, we can see that tooltip is outside of drive geometry outline and tool is driven tangentially to drive area. Contact point is aligned with edge of the surface, well, within the toolpath tolerance. On second example, I want to compare contour area operation, which is way easier to create. but it will never give us as smooth toolpath as Streamline will. Here you can see follow periphery cut pattern. Even if we will use corner smoothing, it still could be better. So let's create streamline operation. As cut area, I select this single surface, and I would expect streamline curves will be created automatically as in previous example. As you can see here, it is not always possible. But I can create it automatically. In this case, I need two flow curves. I select first one and click add new set. And here is the second one. We need to pay attention to directions of each curve. In this case, they should be pointing in the same direction. Also, if curve is closed type, its origin point matters. Let's set rest of the settings regular way. And here is the result. Inner circular shape, very smoothly, little by little, transforms to outer shape of the surface. Way better comparing to what we can get with contour area. Obviously, we can add more flow curves to machine also adjacent faces. To make it possible, I can select more faces as cut area or leave cut area not selected. Thank you for watching, see you in next Technical Tuesday with NXCAM, where I will discuss options of 5-axis finishing sidewalls in deep cavities.